health. Come along with me now. I'll take you on a trip to the supermarkets to show you the better buys and how to shop for health. Shelves are stacked with them. From around the world, nicely packaged food products crying out to be bought. The consumer has the choice, perhaps too many. Seduced by the ads, he grabs the most attractive package that'll give him value for money without giving a thought to its nutritional content. Nutrition Week hopes to change that.
You know, I've always dreaded shopping for groceries, especially since I don't know what to buy. But now that Nutrition Week is on, it's a lot easier to choose, especially when you find a lot of nutritional guides around on the shelves. And I don't know about you, I sure could do some weight loss. Yogurt. One of the best ways for you to lose weight, especially if you're intolerant to milk. I think I'm gonna grab a few. Ah, low-fat milk. Another good way to lose weight. It still has the good taste of milk, but with only half the fat. Ah, just the thing to go with my salads. Salad creams with low saturated fat, especially good for my heart. You know, most people say you have to avoid oily foods. Well, you don't have to cut down the oil totally. You see, if you, like me, like to cook, most supermarkets sell a variety of cooking oils with low saturated fats, ranging from corn oil to soybean oils. Personally, I prefer corn oil. They taste a lot better.
Now, here's something we tend to eat too little of, fiber. That's a pity because it helps lower blood cholesterol, and a lack of it has been linked to colon cancer. And ever since my blood pressure went up, I resolved to cutting down on salt. Now the labels are such a help, don't you think? But they're the only start, and hopefully more consumers will begin to read the labels on the products themselves. A good label should give you some directions on preparation, a general description of the product, its shelf life, and whether it contains preservatives, as well as some nutritional information. It's not uncommon to find such information on foreign products, but local ones only carry a list of ingredients. Are the labeling laws lacking in any way?
I think the labeling laws in Singapore are quite adequate. But perhaps more local manufacturers can maybe take the initiative to start include nutritional information, some basic nutritional information in the labels. For example, things like protein, carbohydrate, fat, sodium, dietary fiber, and energy content.
At CESA's laboratories, manufacturers can get their food products analyzed for their nutritional content. Normally, such information is necessary when the product is to be exported. Now that's because most big buyers and consumers in developed countries demand it. Unlike our local consumers, who may not understand what the fine print on the package means.
If it is to be effective, I think this information must be clear, simple, and uniform so that consumers can understand them. On the other hand, I feel also consumers should be educated or informed of what their dietary requirements are on a daily basis so that what the information given by the label can be comprehended by consumers.
Let's face it, most of us are less concerned about the hole in our stomachs than the one in our pockets, and more influenced by the external package than what's inside it. When was the last time you bought something for the container? But while the colour of the container shouldn't matter, its material should. Consider cans and the tons of food that we consume from them. The good thing about them is that you can store them for a year in your cupboard for that rainy day. And the nutrition and taste will still be there. Canned foods contain no preservatives. The food is treated under very high temperatures in the sterilization chamber. Now, the same method is used to sterilize pouches, which can then be reheated by immersing them in boiling water. Pouches are one of the latest advances in food packaging. And while they may not replace cans entirely, they certainly have their advantages.
Canning technology has been around for a very long time. And as compared to pouches, the reason, one of the few reasons why pouches was developed was so that you get a lighter product, for example, as opposed to cans, you get a lighter product. And also because of the nature of the product, it's flatter as compared to the can, which is more round and tall. The heat penetration into pouches is faster. So you do not have to overheat the product to get a commercially sterile product. And because the processing time is shorter, you get better flavor retention and better nutritional retention.
How to make perishable ingredients like onions last longer without losing any of the nutritional value? Now that's the name of the processing game. Food technologists are also cracking their heads over preserving proteins and meat for longer periods and are making no bones about it. Stewing in their laboratories are fresh schemes to prolong the life of fresh foods. At CISA, research on improving sterilization techniques is being carried out. One of their projects is continuous sterilization. What this convoluted mass of steel does is sterilize food at the highest temperatures in the shortest time possible. That way, the essential nutrients are not destroyed. For the consumer, it means products with no artificial preservatives. More and more of these natural foods are appearing on shelves lately, grossing millions for manufacturers each year. But the word natural is bandied around so much that one suspects it's more of an advertising gimmick than anything else. Perhaps the thing to remember is to eat a variety of foods, both natural and processed, because there is no substitute for fresh foods straight from the farms.